Hi there, I'm Sam Jewell, an engineer here at Grafana Labs. Let's talk about SQL Expressions, which is available on private preview in Grafana 12. So why make this change? Well, Grafana users often want to transform the data that they get back from their data source queries. This is valuable for a few reasons. It allows data to be joined, ordered, filtered, and aggregated before it is then visualized in a Grafana dashboard. It can be used to combine data from disparate data sets. So for example, this is a query that returns metrics data, time series data, which is coming back from a logging data source, in this case, Loki. And this query is responding with tabular data, which has come back from a SQL data source, in this case, BigQuery. And with the SQL expression, we've been able to combine those disparate types of data from disparate data sources at query time in Grafana with a single SQL transformation. And we haven't had to run any ETL pipelines. We haven't had to run any data warehouse or data lake to do this. So that is super powerful. And last but not least, this gives us the ability to alert on data that has been transformed. So you can see we're loading the data sources here into a new alert rule. There's the logs query, here's the BigQuery query, and then here is the SQL expression powering an alert. And you can see if we preview it, you can see it's firing. This query was not written to power an alert with many labels, but you can see that the alert is working already. So now you may know that we have for a long time already had this menu of transformations in Grafana, which is powerful, but there are limits. Users might want a transformation which is not yet supported. And sometimes it's hard to kind of find the option that you need. And after you've added a few of these transformations, it can start to become quite unwieldy, sometimes a bit slow. But we found we can simplify and speed things up by replacing lists of, you know, 4 or 6 or 10 transformations into, you know, a single SQL expression. And moreover, Grafana transforms did not support alerting because they're all running in the browser. Okay, so how do we go about actually adding a SQL expression from scratch? Here I've got a brand new dashboard with a new panel. And I'm just going to use the test data source to add some dummy data that we can use to test this out. So I'm going to use this population data, which has some rows and columns you can see. And I could visualize that in a bar chart. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is switch back to the table view here. That's important so we can see our rows and columns and how our fields have been named so we can reference them. So now we're going to start transforming. We'll come down here and click add expression, that button there. And then from this list, we need to pick the bottom option, SQL. Transform data using SQL, which uses the MySQL syntax. And you'll see there's some more help text here. Okay. Now, straight away, we can run that. And what you'll see is that there's now two tables we can choose from. This top one is coming back from query A and this bottom one from query B. We want to work with B now and start evolving our query. So we'll pick that. And actually, I'd recommend you hide the response from query A because that's now a dependency that will be evaluated when query B runs. Okay, so the first thing to know is that here these field names are available to your SQL query as column names. So what we can do, we can say select state, comma, let's try 2020. And actually we need backticks because this is a number. And so we've been able to reference the field names as column names here in the query. The other thing to note is that the reference, the name of the query here, if this was called pop for population, for example, and we tried to run that, we'd get an error, table not found A. That's because it can't find this table A here. So you have to, so the table, the query names or the query references to your data sources are available in the query as table names. That's how you've got to refer to them. So there you go. And we're away now, so we can start transforming the data. We could limit to two rows, for example. We could rename 2020 as latest, and we could even bring back, you know, let's say we brought back 1980 data as well, and we could see that. Now, at this point, we could try to visualize the final result. So I'll show you that. And you might have spotted I've made a mistake here. You've seen what the solution is already, but I wanted also to illustrate the power. One of the powerful things about SQL is that we live in the age of generative AI now and LLMs. And so some of us might not consider our SQL ability to be very strong, but LLMs and generative AI are fantastic at explaining and understanding and writing SQL because it's prevalent. There's so many examples out there in the world. So if I want to fix this, I can just copy it and land it into, you know, LLM service. I can say, you know, I'm not seeing data from 1980. I'm just seeing that value over and over. What did I do wrong? And it's going to give me a solution here. I'll just copy that, drop it in, and let's see if that fixes the issue. It does. Look, I've got my original numeric data back, and there we go. I've transformed the data successfully. And just to illustrate a bit more how I've been using LLMs to write my SQL queries, I've got here, I had a kind of regular expression here, and I wanted to implement it in my SQL instead for lifting a substring. It wrote the query for me straight away, and then I extended it further with grouping by one of the fields, which was named noun. And lo and behold, there it goes. It just keeps building longer and longer SQL queries, and I just keep dropping them in and seeing how they go. So that's SQL Expressions. It's fantastically powerful. Many of us here at Grafana are super excited about it. So please reach out to us if you'd like to join the private preview. We would love to have you try it out and to hear your feedback. Thank you.